Last week, the Rays received permission to explore a plan that would have the team split their home games between Tampa and Montreal. Yesterday, owner Stuart Steinberg addressed the move by saying it's unlikely the team will play in Tampa full-time longer than the 2027 season when its lease ends in the city. Oh, my gosh. Oh, they're averaging like 14,000 fans a game.
Right.
That's second lowest in the baseball right,
right
now.
Right, right.
What's the latest?
Well, this is, to me, Mike, the big takeaway of the press conference that Steinberg gave was that note that you just mentioned about how he acknowledges that the odds of this team remaining in Tampa Bay on a full-time basis beyond 2027 are rather slim. That is a huge story. Mm-hmm. That means this team is going somewhere. Now, the question is, are they going to be going to Montreal for half of a season to keep baseball alive in Tampa Bay, or will they be going wholesale somewhere else by the middle part of the coming decade? That's the question they're wrestling with right now. And Rob, the mayor of St. Petersburg, Rick Kreisman, is not a fan of this proposal. He has not totally shot it down, but it's going to take some time to work through the governments in both cities, both countries for that matter, and it's a very difficult situation for Tampa Bay.
I have a problem with both, and I don't understand why baseball is going to go back to Montreal. I don't speak French, but I say P.U. to this because there's no way. They're romanticizing with Montreal. It failed there. At one point, they didn't even have a radio deal. You needed two tin cans and a string to listen to the Expo games. No Montreal, no Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay's been a failure. I'm sorry, Major League Baseball needs to take a look at somewhere else. I would go to Portland. I would give some city like that a chance rather than revisit two failed places. I'm not with this plan. I think it's a bad plan. Baseball needs a better plan than this. Mm.
My friend, we disagree on this matter. I think Montreal, to me, is a major league city. It's also the largest market in the U.S. or Canada without a major league baseball team right now.
And for a reason.
Well, but listen, when you think about the way the media rights work, or at least the way they used to work, it's a fundamentally different circumstance now. Mm-hmm. You can sell the rights, TV, radio, in both languages. You make double the money when you think about it that way. And one of the aspects of the way that attendance worked in Montreal, they did turn out for a good team. You look back at those videos of the early 90s when they were competitive, the fans came out there in a way they never really have in Tampa Bay. So they've shown up for a winner. Things got a little awkward at the end with the MLB ownership of the club there in the early 2000s. So I don't think you can really judge Montreal based on the early 2000s. The 80s and 90s are a much better measure. I believe Montreal would support a team, especially with an outdoor ballpark downtown, and maybe the sharing agreement, while not traditional, could work.
Giants definitely going to be sellers.
Yes,
trade
yes.
Deadline. We know that. Names being thrown out there. Madison Bumgarner, who is lights out in the postseason. Will Smith, the baseball player, not the catcher for the Dodgers.
Right.
Not the actor, but
yes,
their reliever also out there. What are you hearing?
Well, number one, Bumgarner is not close to being traded. I was told by a source today, Mike, that there's
not close.
Not close. Not close.
Okay.
In other words, it'll be probably later after the All-Star game, in between those, probably the All-Star game and the July 31st trade deadline. I think he's going to go somewhere, just not quite yet. One team I would mention on Bumgarner to keep a close eye on here, the Atlanta Braves. They've got Mike Foltynewicz down in the minor leagues. He's really struggled. I'm told Bumgarner, potentially, of course, he's from North Carolina. If he goes to the Braves, maybe he would want to sign there long-term during the offseason. So I think stay tuned there. The Brewers, though, an excellent fit for Bumgarner as well. But you mentioned Will Smith. Will Smith, to me, is probably, guys, the most talked-about player in baseball right now among the executives. Because everybody needs bullpen. And he, you think about that left side, the slider that he's got right there, a devastating pitch. Interestingly, we talked about this earlier in the week, the possibility of maybe him even going to the Dodgers in a rare trade between those two teams.
Ooh,
but Boston, I would say, is a fit there. Atlanta as well because of their bullpen needs. Rob, he fits for just about every single team. I am certain he's going to be somewhere else by July 31st.
I want to see Madison Bumgarner in the Bronx. The Yankees need to stop being cheap. I'm telling you, the last time they won a World Series, sports writers were still using typewriters. It's been that long. It's been a decade.
2009.
The time, though, is to go out and go get you another starter. They need one. They have a great bullpen, a great lineup, but one more starter, a guy like him who's had nothing but success in the postseason, would strengthen that rotation. He's the guy who needs to be with the Yankees.
When's the last time you heard somebody say the Yankees are being cheap?
They are being cheap.
I mean, well, first of all,
Dallas Keuchel was on the market.
He's got to want to go to the Yankees for somebody like Bumgarner or whatever. Think about that.
Yes.
So cheap.
Well, I'm going from the Keuchel. He was linked to the Yankees. All the talk was about him going there. And the Yankees didn't pull the trigger because they had a number set.
They did.
And they weren't going to budge. They have all the money in the world.
Is that cheap or smart baseball?
Well, and that's... You're both right.
Okay.
Okay, so it may well be smart baseball in terms of really drawing a line and being firm there, but Rob is correct in that Keuchel signed a one-year deal. And it was at a number that he obviously the Braves were comfortable giving him, and that the Yankees, think about that, to Rob's point, the Yankees could not outbid the Braves for Dallas Keuchel. When you think about that, it really does put things in perspective. And they have to, and to Rob's point, too, they've got to be careful here. Luis Severino, he's supposed to come back in the second half, but you don't really know that he's been out since spring training. Domingo Germán, they relied on him so much. He has been injured as well. And we talked about today, Paxton hasn't quite been who they thought he was going to be. And the final point I'll make here, and I know, Mike, you're going to love this one.
Okay.
If you're going to make a trade, though, if you're the Yankees, the one reason why I would say maybe no Bumgarner.
Scherzer.
You've been saying that. Now, listen, I think the Nationals are going to try to keep him, certainly for all the obvious reasons. He's an amazing pitcher going to the Hall of Fame. However, the Yankees, if you're going to make a move, the reason why I wouldn't say Bumgarner necessarily is you want to find somebody that can replace CeCe next year when he retires. So get someone who's controllable, unlike Bumgarner the rental, Scherzer, Stroman, Matthew Boyd potentially in Detroit.
We'll see what happens. Yankees doing fine without all those guys right now.